ingredients, Cheesy Poofs can really give you that quick pick-me-up. So remember,
I love Cheesy Poofs. You love Cheesy Poofs. If we didn't eat Cheesy Poofs, we'd be...
Lame.
Radiohead posters. And he's reading a magazine about Radiohead.
What's a Radiohead?
You know, that band that sings that song. Lemon creep.
What am I doing here?
Oh, Jesus, don't start singing, Ned.
So, the subject is a big Radiohead fan, huh? Maybe I should come up with a little scheme that involves them.
Nice thinking, young hunter.
Well...
What?
I'm looking in Scott's parents' room. Scott's mom's about to take off her bra.
What? Give me those! Holy crow, he's right, Ned! Mrs. Tenorman's letting the twins out!
Let me see.
Radiohead. Yes, of course.
Dear God, they're even bigger than I ever imagined.
Let me see.
Here you go. Wow, those were great. Maybe I should go grab some beers, Ned. Ned, what the... Are you jacking it?
Kinda.
Well, stop it!
Hey, what the hell are you doing out there?
Oh, crap!
Who's out there?
Ned, for Christ's sake, stop jacking it.
I can't.
Don't think I don't see you. I know who you are, and I'm calling the police.
Oh, I gotta get out of here.
Do you like it, Scott? I call it Mr. and Mrs. Tenorman Chili.
Oh, my God! Oh, my God!
I made you eat your parents.
Oh, and look at this! Little Stan Marsh actually has a shot at the goal!
Oh!
Stan! Shoot it!
Time is running out. Stan Marsh with a chance to win!
You got it, Stan!
Take the shot! Take the shot!
Game, and how disappointing.
Yes! Oh, let me taste your tears, Scott. Your tears are so yummy and sweet.
Dude, I think it might be best for us to never piss Cartman off again.
Good call. Oh, the tears of unfathomable sadness. Yummy.
In an effort to comfort the anguished cries of children everywhere, your local cable company has decided to drop all networks that sexualize spousal homicides from regular programming. Customers still wishing to view true crime networks will now need to purchase a separate package, which will require a technician to service your cable box every night from 2 to 3 a.m. and must include the purchase of 300 channels in Portuguese. We realize this may be an inconvenience to you, and we hope you will voice all your concerns to us. Because at your local cable company, the customer is always our bitch.
You see, Mom, all the kids at school were told to bring a picture of their mom's breasts for anatomy class.
I don't know, son. That sounds awfully strange. You cannot have a picture of my hot breasts.
But, Mom, my teacher will...
No. You gotta go, but, Mom.
But, Mom.
But, Mom.
This is hopeless.
Why don't you just sneak in your mom's closet and get a picture when she's changing clothes?
That's sick, dude. I'm not taking a picture of my mom's boobs.
Oh, no.
No, you're not doing it either. We just have to find something that looks like boobs to take a picture of.
What else has big, round, squishy globes?
You gotta draw the nipples like on the bottom of my ass cheeks.
No, the nipples are more in the middle, see?
Yeah, but Stan's mom is old. That means her nipples sag more to the bottom now.
How do you know? Will you guys trust me? I know this stuff.
All right, fine.
Oh, wait, we forgot the necklace.
Oh, whoa.
God, I hope this works.
All right, start your engine. What's that mean?
That means you flipped a switch that says engine. Is he stupid or what?
Yeah, he's a champion, all right.
The drivers are slowly heading out to follow the pace car.
I'm gonna press the gas pedal and I'm gonna go forward. NASCAR, yeah!
This is just the pace lap. You don't go full speed yet.
Yeah, just the base lap, I'm gonna hit the brake!
The fuck are you doing?
Fuck you, Danny Kirkpatrick! You ain't half as dumb as me! Gas pedal!
Oh, son of a bitch!
Ain't nobody can stop me! Oh boy, I'm gonna get a three-piece meal and crispy strips!
Cartman, you only come to soccer practice on Fridays, and that's only because we get to have Kentucky Fried Chicken afterwards.
Shut up, you shifty Jew! I'll f***ing kill you!
Sorry. I just, you know, when I've been waiting too long for the Colonel's chicken, I get easily agitated.
You're a f***ing asshole, Keeney!
Sorry.
Wow, look at all these guys that want to be my friend. I'll pick Tony316. Huh, Tony. So what are you into? Oh, you know, the usual stuff. Smiley face. Cool, wanna get together, smiley face? Sure, Tony, that would be cute. Winking, smiley face. Meet me at Mel's Buffet Restaurant tomorrow morning. Sounds good, see you then. Clown hat, curly hair, smiley face. You see that, Cloud Frog? Tomorrow I'm gonna meet my first mature friend. Hi, are you Tony?
Yeah, you're Eric?
Yeah.
I brought you some candy.
Wow, cool.
And some books on Kama Sutra.
Neato, having older friends kicks ass. You see, I've really been having a tough time. I've kind of matured faster than my other friends. We don't really relate anymore. And all my friends seem so childish now, you know?
Do you like having your back rubbed?
Yeah, that feels really nice. Thanks.
Hold it right there, scumbag.
Huh?
We monitored your little online chat. Now you're coming with us.
No.
What the hell just happened?
It's the best surprise ever.
Oh, boy.
You ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Just open your mouth and close your eyes and get on your knees.
Okay.
Hang on a second here.
How come I can't see?
Because then it wouldn't be a surprise, would it?
Oh, yeah.
All right, that's good. Okay, open your mouth, Butters. That's good, just like that.
Hey, wait a minute. This ain't a trick, is it? You're not going to stick something yicky in my mouth, are you?
I swear on my mother's life, Butters, I'm not going to stick anything yicky in your mouth.
Okay.
All right, you ready? All right, just, okay, open your, good, okay, here it comes. Just sit really still, okay? Here we go.
Butters!
Whoa! Hey, Dad!
Butters, what are you doing?
I'm getting a surprise!
Oh, my God! My only son reduced to this!
Hey, where'd Eric go?
Butters, how long have you been doing stuff like this?
Like what?
Don't lie to me, Butters!
Shit! Butthole! Hey, Wendy. Dumb bitch! Oh, sorry. Titties! Cock! Ginger retard! Ass licker dick face!
Dude, you better watch it. The principal's right over there.
Oh, good morning, Principal Victoria. Shit balls!
Good morning, Eric.
Did Carmen just say shit balls to the principal?
You didn't hear? Well, Carmen has some mental disease called Tourette syndrome or something.
What?
He's the luckiest kid in the world. If I could say shit balls to the principal, I'd be so happy.
Excuse me, everyone. I guess you might have noticed my awkward tics. Asshole! Pussy asshole! I just want you to know that I can't control it.
It's okay, Eric. We all understand, and we think you're very brave.
He's faking.
Truth is that with the power of Jesus Christ, you can be normal. Now, just to make sure you don't slip up while in camp, we assign every camper an accountability buddy. Let's meet Ryan, your accountability buddy. Ryan thought he could never change, but now he's learning that with the power of Christ and prayer, he can have a whole new life. Over this way, we have the cafeteria. All the meals are served there.
Dumb shit, douchebag! And it means a lot that you're standing here apologizing with your dad and lovely mother. Fat Jew! Jew bitch!
Oh, thank you, Eric.
Thank you. Big nose cake!
Well, I think we can all put this behind us now. Piss out my ass!
Yeah! Piss out your ass right onto Kyle's mom's fat fucking Jew face! Oh, goodness. Excuse me. Jeez, that was a bad one.
For those of you who are new to camp, Pastor Phillips is somebody who has broken free of the bonds that afflict you.
He's bi-curious too?
Not anymore, because Pastor Phillips prayed, and by the hand of Jesus Christ, he's now completely cured. Let's hear it for Pastor Phillips, kids!
Hello, campers! Yes, believe it or not, I myself used to have unclean urges, and like a lot of you, I thought I was just made that way, that I didn't have a choice. But then I realized that God didn't want me to be that way. God wanted me to be a man. So I buckled up in my little suit, and I prayed to be normal, and guess what? It worked!
That's right, kids. You see, right now you're like a paperclip. And just like a paperclip, God needs to bend you and shape you and make you straight.
You think HIV is something to be laughed at, Kyle? Well, let's just see how funny it is now, asshole.
Little boy, have you been having unprotected anal sex?
What? No! Doctor, what are you saying?
We've run every test imaginable. Little Kyle here is infected with HIV.
What? HIV?
It took us a long time to narrow it down, but there is no doubt.
No, that's impossible!
Little boy, are you sure you haven't taken it up the hoo-hoo just once or twice?
No! No, goddammit, no! I'm telling you, you're wrong. There's no way I can have HIV. Unless maybe... Oh, my God. That son of a bitch!
Oh, yeah, look at that.
Dad, you know Mom doesn't want you watching food channels.
I've worked all day. I can watch what I want.
We're gonna take a stick of butter and just smear that all over.
Oh, my God, that's awesome. Oh. Oh, oh. Yeah. Whoa.
Now, let's get that on the grill.
See what he's doing, Stan? He brined that for an hour in the fridge, so now you can sear the shit out of it. Oh.
Look at the char we're getting. That is what we're going for.
Oh, isn't that hot, guys? Oh, yeah. Don't you want to just get in there?
Boys both have the virus, are you sure?
We're not just sure. We're HIV positive.
Will you stop it with that? What part of this is funny to you?
Kyle, we need to try to find
out... What part of being infected with a deadly disease do you find funny?
I don't think it's funny, Kyle.
Then stop saying you're not just sure you're HIV positive. This isn't funny, AIDS isn't funny, dying isn't funny, so shut the fuck up!
Well, excuse me, Kyle, for trying to keep some optimism, you know? You know, sometimes when things seem their darkest, you just need to try and stay HIV positive. But if you want to be so HIV negative all the time...
Knock it off! Right now! This isn't funny! At all!
Are you sure?
Yes!
Are you HIV positive?
Ah! Ow, fuck, Kyle!
Hi there, I'm Amanda. What are you up to?
Oh, hi, I just, thought I'd give the hotline a try. What are you doing?
I'm making a pan-roasted chicken.
Pan-roasted? Like, sear it on the stove and then put in the oven?
Uh-huh. I've just taken the chicken out of the pan. It's so moist. I'm gonna let it rest now, about 5 minutes.
Yeah?
Yeah. Oh, there's lots of brown bits stuck to the bottom of the skillet.
You're gonna deglaze that fucking pan?
Oh, I'm gonna deglaze it. You wanna help me?
If I was there, I would. I'd take some red wine, about a quarter cup, and then a wooden spoon, and I'd deglaze the fuck out of that pan.
I got a wooden spoon right here. It's pretty hard. Yeah, you can put some onion in while you're deglazing. I was thinking about shallots, actually. Oh, yeah. Shallots won't overwhelm the chicken's natural flavors. Fuck yeah.
Randy Marsh!
Oh, Jared!
Hey, guys.
Hey, Randy.
Oh, hey, Randy.
Are you feeling better?
Yeah, no, I'm totally fine now.
You guys should have seen the crap Randy took last night. It was honestly the biggest crap anyone has ever taken. Ever.
Well, I don't know about ever.
I'm telling you, this thing was the size of a freaking football.
I guess it was pretty big.
A football? That's amazing.
I've never heard of one that big.
No, my brother took a crap once that was enormous. It was the biggest in the history of the world, I think.
It wasn't bigger than mine was.
No, seriously, this crap was a monster.
Mine was bigger.
I doubt it.
You want to see it?
Oh, my freaking lord.
Packed full of ingredients, Cheesy Poofs can really give you that quick pick-me-up. So remember...
I love Cheesy Poofs. You love Cheesy Poofs. If we didn't eat Cheesy Poofs, we'd be...
Lame.